हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ डीपोल स्कूल। आई एम मलय सर, योर SST टीचर। दिस इज योर SST बुक ऑफ क्लास 5, प्राची एक्सीलेंस इन सोशल स्टडीज 5। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी स्टडीड अबाउट ग्लोब्स, मैप्स। व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ ग्लोब्स, व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ मैप्स, टाइप्स ऑफ मैप्स, डिरेक्शंस, मेन डिरेक्शंस और यू कैन से कार्डिनल डिरेक्शंस, सब डिरेक्शंस, इंटरमीडिएट डिरेक्शंस, स्केल, टाइप्स ऑफ स्केल एंड मैप्स, टाइप्स ऑफ मैप्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द स्केल। वी हैड कंप्लीटेड दिस मच एंड टुडे लेट अस सी अबाउट कलर स्कीम। सो व्हाट आर कलर स्कीम? ओके, so on the earth you see there are various landforms on the earth like ocean, sea, lakes, rivers, plains, plateaus, mountains, deserts, etc. but it is not possible to draw all these various landforms on the map. so to make it easy, the cartographers have used colors in the maps, and the colors which are colored on the maps, by looking at them we can easily define what is water body, which is a plain, which is a forest cover area, which is an elevation, which is a plateau or a desert, all these things. So to identify these landforms, different landforms on a map, one key is also given in each map. So a legend, it is also called legend, is always made on the map to tell the meaning of the colors used on a map. How? In this way, just see. On each of the maps it must be written. For example, you see blue color is water bodies, so wherever you see blue color on the maps, this is a map, here you are seeing blue colors, that means these are water bodies. Okay, this blue color is water body. Green color is plain. Okay, so green color is plain or forest area. Brown color is elevation or plateau area. So you see here also in the map, this yellow color given here, this yellow color is the plateau. Brown colors are elevations here, brown colors are here, you see little bit brown colors are given here. So these are elevations. Elevation means table land, a land which is raised than that of other surrounding areas. Okay, and green color here, green color is here, green, you see all these areas green are there. So green means in this much areas in real forest cover is also there. Okay, so in this way, by looking at the key, we can easily study a map. Okay, so in this way it is about color scheme. Next, another one scheme is given here, that is conventional signs and symbols. Just like various landforms on the earth, we have also international boundaries, roads, railway, water system, vegetation, monuments, mines, factories and different industries, so many things are there. So it is not possible for the cartographers also to draw all these things on a map. So to show them on a map, they used some signs or symbols, you can say. Okay, by looking at them we can easily clarify that whether which is a international boundary, which is a district boundary, which is a metal road, which is a railway, what is a, you can say, water system, which is different monuments. So in this way, so some symbols are also given in your book, just have a look at them. you see, whenever we see this type of dots, okay, a thick dot and thick line one after another consecutively, that means it is an international border. If it is given as a thin line and a small dot, it is called state boundary. District boundaries are also given with only lines. You see, metal rod. If this type of lines are drawn, that means it is metal rod. If dot dot double lines are made here, you see, it is unmetal rod. If this type of lines are drawn on a map, it is footpath. So in this way, all the boundaries, roads, railways, water system, stream, riverbed, tank, dam, canal, whether riverbed with stream, tank, bridge, vegetation, where grass is grown, which is a swamp area, which is coniferous forest, which are forts, which are temples, which are churches, mosques, all these things are also shown on a map, okay. And on that particular map, you see here, conventional symbols used on a map, it is written here. This type of key or legend, you can say, it is also given there, okay. So that by looking at the key, you can easily find out which is what, okay. So in this way, a map is also a storehouse of information. So from the map, many things we came to know, okay. So again, let us take a review. From a globe, we can get an overall data about the shape of the earth. From the maps, many things we can, many information about the earth we can get, starting from about the countries, states, administrative divisions, cities, towns and villages. We can see on the political maps, we can find out physical maps, in the physical maps, like the features like mountains, rivers, plains, plateaus and other areas. In thematic maps, we can easily see the rainfall, forest, soil, weather, roads, crop distribution, all these things. With the help of map, we can find out the four directions, main directions or cardinal directions, and four intermediate directions. By using the colors given on a map, we can define which is what type of landform that particular area belongs to. We can calculate which is ocean, which is rivers, which is plain, which is plateau, what is which area is mountain, which area is desert, okay. And finally, last but not least, you see, with the help of conventional signs and symbols, we can easily find out the areas or the things in the map, like boundaries, roads, railways, water system, vegetation, monuments, settlements. So this much vast amount of knowledge is given by a map and also a globe. So a map is also called a storehouse of information. This much for today. Thank you.